All right, everyone. Well, welcome to the show and to our What's New at Garmin presentation. My name is Joe Stewart. I'm the regional sales manager for Garmin covering the Southeast US and Latin America. And we're going to cover a pretty broad topic today. I've been looking forward to this presentation for a long time. We're going to talk about our integrated flight decks a little bit about our autopilots, our new GI 275, and then summarize with some programs that we have running at our Garmin dealers here at the show, and some panel photos of static display aircraft we have on display here that I think you're gonna really like to see. So let's get started. So the first off is this airplane. What's new at Garmin is the SR22 retrofit for the older G1 and G2 Ciruses. It's got a G500 TXI primary flight display with synthetic vision, a GI 275 standby display. It has a GTN 750XI and 650XI, FlightStream 510, GPS navcoms, and our three-axis GFC 500 all-digital autopilot. And if you want to see an example in this configuration, outside of Hangar C, Sarasota Avionics has got a beautiful demo that they just finished retrofitting, and take a look at that. I've got a panel photo to show you at the end. All right, so other new stuff, Autoland. So during the pandemic, we have been working with our OEM partners, Piper, Cirrus, and Daher Sakata, and have certified Autoland on these single engine turbine aircraft. And the way it works is if the pilot is incapacitated, any passenger can press the button, it activates the system, will select an airport based on runway length and approximation and availability of medical facilities. It will navigate to that airport, dodging around terrain and weather. It will couple an LPV approach to the appropriate runway based on the data link winds, automatically deploy the landing gear and flaps, use a radar altimeter to let the airplane know when to flare, and then differential braking to keep the airplane straight on the runway, and then shut the engine down. And all the time, it's communicating inside the cockpit to the passengers and externally to ATC and the control tower, or CTAF frequency, letting everyone know that there's an emergency. So very, very exciting about this, and we look forward to bringing this to new models as well. eVTOL, electric vertical takeoff and landing. So we are working with Joby on, they call it the Joby S4. This is a six propeller, articulating propeller airplane or VTOL plane equipped for the future air taxi market. So it's going to give us the ability to leverage Garmin's experience in flight control systems and our autopilots and integrated flight decks to bring the cockpit for this new eVTOL airplane. So keep an eye on this. This is an interesting new area in aviation. Okay, so talking more about retrofit avionics for aircraft that are here, right here at the show, let's talk about the GI 275 flight instrument. So you can see we have an EIS version, engine indication system. You have a attitude indicator, AI, or attitude direction indicator, an HSI or HSI map below that, and then on the upper right part, it's a multifunction display. So the primary attitude indicator, it can be it can be your primary source of airspeed, attitude, altitude, and heading. So it's a 4-in-1 attitude indicator. It's compatible with both Garmin GFC 500 and GFC 600 autopilots, as well as third-party autopilots. So we have different variants for those two situations. You have optional synthetic vision, and pilot selectable reference markers. So this little circular display has touchscreen on there that you can use the touchscreen to set your altitude pre-select or indicated airspeed climbs and descents if you have it hooked up to the autopilot. And you can use the knob as well. It has automatic reversionary capability. So if in the unlikely event, let's say Murphy's Law struck and you lost your alternator, and you're really having a bad day and you lost the number one GI-275, it has automatic reversionary mode so that it can bring the attitude indicator to the bottom display. So we have a kit that we just announced at the show that is designed for that exact situation. It includes the magnetometer and dual AHARs, so you have dual attitude indicator, and a battery, a backup battery, and you can get a second one as well. Okay, you can have your GI-275 be an HSI or HSI map. And this is a very capable system. You can have it show ILS-1, ILS-2, GPS-1 or GPS-2 for approaches. So you can control two separate GPS navcoms and take advantage of showing the approaches on your HSI. You've got a built-in VFR GPS with this. So in the case, if you were a VFR pilot, you can actually navigate with the GI-275. Your installer would just hook it up to its own GPS antenna, and then you can go direct to any airport that you want. So it's a very, very flexible unit. It can be used for IFR or VFR. It can be a CDI. So a lot of you may fly airplanes that have traditional course deviation indicators, you know, right next to the navigator, maybe next to a navcom. Well, the GI-275 will replicate that familiar display format for you. So as just one of the options there, you can make it an HSI. I happen to think once you fly with an HSI, you know, you'll never go back. Those of you that have flown with HSIs. But it's nice to know if you like the CDI, you can put that in there. But if you're updating your CDI, it's not just a CDI, it's a multifunction display CDI. So you can show traffic, weather, moving map. It has Garmin target trend relative motion vectors. You know, and that's so if you're chasing a slower target, it will point the vector at you. And then if you slow down, so you have negative closure, it points away from you. So it gives you an earlier and better indication of a potential traffic situation. That is synchronized with all of the other Garmin displays showing the same ADS-B traffic picture. You can show terrain with forward-looking terrain alerting with both visual and verbal audible alerts. You can show your active flight plan next to the weather and the terrain. And you can show what you have a complete waypoint library in the GI-275 as well. So all of your frequencies, all the information you need is right there. You can hook this up to be a radar altimeter. And that's popular in the helicopter world, but some of the larger Part 23 airplanes have radar altimeters. It's sort of a flare assist, right? You know exactly how many feet you are from the bottom of the plane to the runway. Now, for our Part 25 customers who fly in business jets and larger aircraft, the GI-275 can be what's called an IVSI, Instantaneous Vertical Speed Indicator. This is what's used on airliners for TCAS-2, Traffic Collision Avoidance System. So it not only tells you where the traffic is, it also gives indications to climb or descend, because it's talking with it when you have a TCAS-2 system. And the advantage of the Garmin system here is that it's plugging into the Garmin high-speed data bus. So if you have a Citation jet, for example, and you want to have your IVSI display on a G700 TXI and on the GI-275 and on your GTN 750XI, you can have synchronized IVSI in your cockpit. So this is going to be nice also for customers that just want the single display for their Part 25 airplanes. we have the GFC 500 and GFC 600 autopilot interface. And you can see the autopilot enunciations are on the bottom third of the display there. You have your diamonds for LPV vertical path and for your course deviation indicator left or right. You have a heading bug, vertical speed bug, airspeed target, flight director command bars, if your autopilot has a flight director, and localizer and glide slope, and your autopilot mode enunciations. We will interface with third-party autopilots as well. So again, there's a variant of the GI 275. If you've got a Century 2, Century 3, or Bendix King autopilot, you can interface that with the GI 275. Notice on the bottom there, there's air data. You can get optionally hook this up to an air temperature probe. So that's going to add true airspeed, ground speed, your outside air temperature, and winds. So you have like a little windsock right on the GI 275 there for doing approaches. Very nice. We have engine indication systems for single or twin engine, Lycoming or Continental, four-cylinder or six-cylinder engines. And we have a number of different kits. We can show engine, fuel, and electrical data. We have a lean assist capability. For those of you that fly engines lean of peak, you can do those lean of peak calculations very easily on the GI 275. It has exceedance alerts that can be programmed by the installer and selected by the pilot. So let's say that you had a Cessna 172 and you were going to lease it back to a flight school, and you told the flight school management, you said, hey, I don't want anyone over revving my engine. I don't want to go more than 2,700 RPMs. Well, you can set up an enunciation at 2,600 RPMs so that it won't, to help protect your engine. So, and it'll give enunciations that the pilot will see. And then it has the ability to data link or Wi-Fi the engine information from the EIS and display it on a Garmin iPad running Garmin Pilot. So you can add an additional big engine indication system display. Well, it's not only a display then, it will also download that information when your complete flight, take it to the FBO or at home, upload it to the Fly Garmin cloud, and then you've got a complete record of your engine performance during the flight. So let's say you're flying along on a VFR flight and you hear the engine cough, right? And analyzing the information, you can go back to see where you flew on that flight and look at the actual temperatures. So instead of going to your mechanic and saying, okay, I've got a six-cylinder engine, check all 12 spark plugs for fouling, you can now go back and see which cylinder was higher or lower than the other cylinders. It helps you diagnose the problem right in the cockpit. You can also give access to the Garmin cloud to your mechanic. So if you want them, that mechanic, to look at your engine performance, they can see real-time engine, or right after the flight, but they can see what happened on that particular flight to help diagnose it. So we're getting better and better with engine diagnostics to help the pilot. That's a picture of the Fly Garmin site and what the EIS looks like on your iPad. Again, it's sending that over via Wi-Fi. You can use the GI 275 as a standby display. Now, we've been talking about it in these primary instruments. We've got many of our customers that are putting GI 275s as a standby. It will have, again, works perfectly with third-party autopilots or our GFC 500 autopilot or our GFC 600. Heading bug sync, barrow sync, heading airspeed bug sync, and a nice feature of this as a standby is that you can use it as a multifunction display when it's not being used as a standby display. So if you've got a legacy standby display that just does that, you now have a standby display and multifunction display. And by the way, that as a standby, that will back up G1000 airplanes. It will back up a wide variety of Garmin and third-party primary flight displays. So we have a new GI 275 kit that we've just announced before the show here. Basically, what we've done is combine two GI 275 with Adahars with a magnetometer that gives you heading with the temperature probe that adds all the air data, packaged together and discounted it. So if you're interested in a dual GI 275, please talk to one of our Garmin dealers here at the show. The price, if you're interested in the dual GI 275 with the Garmin autopilot interface, is $79.95. It's $84.95 with the third-party autopilot adapter. We also, at the show, we have reduced the price of synthetic vision from $995 to $500, so about a 50% discount in the synthetic vision. So you can get a very, very nice complete package purchasing the GI 275s this way. Please contact your Garmin dealer. We've got several here at the show, Sarasota Avionics, Gulf Coast Avionics. Sarasota's in Hangar C, Gulf Coast is in Hangar D. We also have Boca Air Maintenance out here in the front. The GSB-15. Now, we had a new announcement at the show that we've had the dual USB-A's, high power USB chargers for some time now. The unique benefit of a Garmin USB charger is that it not only has enough power to charge two iPads while they're at full brightness, but it also has a data updating function that when it's paired with a GI 275, it makes keeping the system software and database updates easier. Now, you can update your GI 275 two ways. You can do it wirelessly. If you happen to use Garmin Pilot, you can download all the databases on Garmin Pilot and then wirelessly Wi-Fi them into the GI 275, or you can use a USB cable. And our customers say they've really liked using the cable. And we've introduced two new variants of the USB chargers. We now have a USB C and A. If you have some, you know, in the iPhone world, the older ones would use USB A's and the new ones are using USB C's. Other customers have all USB C, so you can get a dual USB C as well. And again, high power. They have blue halo lighting that is adjustable. And we have two different variants of all of these USB chargers. You have one that goes in the front panel where the wires come out the back. And then we've got another variant where the wires come out below, and that's designed for going into the side, like the armrest in the back seats. So you can, it's a very shallow space. So we've got the USB chargers to fit pretty much any need in general aviation now. And the price of those is $399 for those USB chargers. Okay, updates on our GTN 750XI and 650XI. The XI is our new variation of, and it's a fourth generation Garmin Navigator. We originally came out with the GTN series back in 2011, and the XI series add a lot of new features. They have much faster processors, so the benefit is you're gonna have much faster startups in the morning when you first fly. It's also gonna update your databases a lot faster. Things like graphical NexRad is gonna be a lot smoother and more fluid now. And the touchscreen is much more responsive than before. We have, this is a direct slide-in replacement for existing GTNs. So if you bring it to your Garmin dealer, many of our dealers are running trade-in programs right now. We don't have one from Garmin, but please talk to your Garmin dealer if you're interested in upgrading it. It's a very nice performance improvement. And I'm gonna show you that the new GTN XI has some unique features that are not offered on the legacy GTNs. It has higher and brighter and higher resolution, about double the pixels, and much more responsive to touch inputs. We have, 50% faster database verification, mentioned that. Okay, so the new system software, so we not only came out with the new hardware during the pandemic, we came out with a new system software upgrade that adds new features and benefits to that new hardware. And that's GTN XI version 20.1 software. It adds glide range ring so that you can have, and this is terrain and wind customized glide range ring. So if you're flying over a valley, a mountain valley, it's going to show the range ring elongated in the valley and shortened next to the mountains. It helps the pilot select the best airport to land. It considers wind and terrain data. Glide range ring is mirrored if you have a GTN XI with a G500 TXI. It's mirrored on all of your Garmin displays as well. So that's a unique benefit of going all Garmin in this case. It has quicker page navigation. So you have three ways of interfacing with a GTN. You know, you can use the triple action knob in the lower right corner, and use the touch screen, and you can use Telligence Voice Command, which your Garmin dealer will install a push to command button. You speak 300 different commands, and it carries out those commands on the GTN. So lots of nice improvements there. Remote radio control. So if you have dual GTN XIs in the cockpit, you can now control both VHF nav and VHF comm from a single GTN 750. And remember that, because one of the pictures I'm going to show you in a moment is an F-33 Bonanza that's parked right over here by Hangar D, where they've put, with the two GTN split apart, he can control both comms from a single GTN, and we weren't able to do that before. So a great time-saving capability there. So enhanced knobs and buttons. We've added menu structures so that you can rapidly use the knobs and buttons without using the touchscreen at all. Much faster than before. We've enhanced the touchscreen by adding 9 new pilot customized quick shortcuts on the touchscreen. So you can program it, those functions that you use the most for rapid access. And then the third time-saving feature is the Telligence Voice Command. You can do things like, if you're coming into Lakeland here, if you have Lakeland as the last waypoint in your flight plan, you can say, load destination tower, and it'll put KLAL and the frequency right in the GTN for you. It's a wonderful capability and very popular.
Does it do that through your headset?
Yeah, it does through your headset. Yeah. Okay, so a couple of programs. We have one called Couple Up Your Savings. This is if you purchase a GFC 500 Autopilot, which I'm going to tell you about in a moment, and a GTN XI, one of the GTNs we just talked about, it's a $1,000 rebate available. And if you get a GFC 600 Autopilot plus the GTN XI, it's a $2,000 rebate. Okay? For more information on this program, there's a little QR code in the upper right corner. If you point your camera at it, you can get more information on that, or come up after the presentation and I'll tell you more about it. Okay, autopilots. Well, this has been one of the just smoking hot upgrade products for us. Over the last 3 years, we started our line of Garmin retrofit autopilots back in 2018, and we now have something on the order of 230 model variants covered by either the GFC 500 or GFC 600 autopilot. These are all digital autopilots. They all use, we call them smart servos, so it gives, the perceivable benefit is that you're gonna feel nice 1G level loss. You've got variable torque, variable speed servos. So your electric pitch trims fast when you're flying slow and trims slow when you're flying fast, as you would want it to. It's going to give you nice 1G level loss from below or from above. It gives you nice attitude-based autopilot features like indicated airspeed, climb and descent, coupled VNAV, your GTN series. If you're coming into Lakeland or in Orlando, you know, they're not going to, if you're at 17,000 feet, they're not going to give you one descent right down to pattern altitude. They're always going to put you on some sort of arrival procedure, a multi-step down procedure. Well, this autopilot will fly that, integrated with your GTN 750. So 182 models approved. We've, and again, we have the $1,000 rebate if you purchase the GFC 500 with the GTN 750. If you want to see the current status of the GFC 500 list, if you go to garmin.com/GFC500 or point your camera at that QR code in the upper right corner, you can see the current status of our approvals. The list, we have the currently approved ones, the ones that are in flight test right now, and ones that we intend to start in the next year. And speaking of approvals, we just this last week got the Cicada TB20 and TB21 added to the GFC 500. So that should be, that's good news for our Cicada customers. We've added additional in progress and additional aircraft to the flight test programs. The ones highlighted are the Cessna 210D, Delta Echo Foxtrot, and Turbo 210 Foxtrot models. The Mooney M20, the C, D, and E, those are the short body Moonies. We're adding the Beechcraft 35 Bonanza, some of the older Bonanzas, to the program, the C, D, E, F, and G 35. And we are adding the Cirrus SR-20 to the program as well. We already have the Cirrus SR-22 approved. I'm gonna show you a picture of that in a moment. So for the pricing, two-axis autopilot, if you've got with two servos and with a G5, because the GFC 500 requires either a G5 or a GI-275, a G3X, to drive, to be the attitude source for the autopilot. So if you include that with a G5, you're starting at just under $10,000. If you get a two-axis system with electric pitch trim, you're starting at just under $12,000. You'd be at just under $15,000 if you had a three-axis four-servo system with dual GI-275s, or excuse me, with dual G5s. And contact your Garmin dealer. A good rule of thumb to remember when you're thinking about the labor costs to put these in, about 20 labor hours per servo. So if you're gonna have a two-axis autopilot, which is roll and pitch, 1, 2, and then you have electric pitch trim, that's your third servo, 20, 40, 60 labor hours, and shop rates, you know, say they're $100 an hour, that'd be about $6,000 of labor. So just to get a kind of take a swag at the labor costs, that's a good way to do it. GFC 600. So this is one of the really interesting new programs that we've done. It's called Smart Rudder Bias for twin engine airplanes. Smart Rudder Bias, the way that works is it relies on the principle of differential percent power. So to get this feature, you need a Garmin PFD, you need Garmin engine indication system, and a Garmin GFC 600 autopilot. When the EIS detects that one engine is 30% or more less than the other engine, it automatically engages the autopilot to bank into the good engine, yaw into the good engine, and use electronic stability control to maintain blue line, or minimum controllable airspeed. Then it also gives you an immediate indication of which engine has lost power to avoid the problem of shutting down the good engine, right? So this is anyone who flies multi-engine aircraft know that when you practice for your multi-engine rating, that is one of the most stressful things, and because you have to act very quickly when if there's an engine out situation. So this helps the pilot. It helps you recognize the situation and automatically uses the autopilot to help the pilot control and fly the aircraft safely. Once you've shut down and feathered the bad engine, then you can turn off smart rudder bias and just fly it on one engine back to your airport. So a great safety enhancement, and we've added this to the Beech B-58 Baron and the Piper Navajo. And we're going to be adding all of the other aircraft that we, the twin engine piston aircraft that we have already certified for the GFC 600, including the Cessna 340, Cessna 414, Cessna 421 Golden Eagle. All of those airplanes, we are going to add smart rudder bias to that as well. Okay. I was asked by our flight test manager to let everyone know that we are looking for a PA-31-300, a Piper Chieftain without winglets, with a GTN or GTN XI, G600 TXI, and Garmin EIS for our autopilot testing. It's a pretty nice deal. If we select your airplane to use in the Garmin flight test program, basically you get a free autopilot and the free installation. So and in this case, it would be probably $40,000 to $50,000 value. So the downside of it is that we need your airplane for 6 to 8 months. So it's not the right deal for everyone, but it is an extraordinary deal for some customers. So if you all know of anyone that has a Piper Chieftain in this configuration and would be interested in letting us use it at either our Kansas City or Salem, Oregon flight test facilities, please contact, go to garmin.com/GFC600. And on the bottom of that list, there's a list of supported aircraft. On the bottom is a link where you can register your aircraft for that program. So please, please do that if it's applicable. The GFC 600 starts at about 21,000, and a three axis with electric pitch trims about 26,000, 25,850. New and current promotions. Again, couple up your savings rebate. That's the marketing name for the promotion we talked about before. If you buy a GFC 500 and a GTN, it's a $1,000 rebate, or a GFC 600 and a GTN XI, it's a $2,000 rebate. That program goes through June 18th, 2021. Okay, want to go through a couple of the products that we have here at the show that our Garmin dealers have. First one is the D2 Air. This is our new, we came out with this about a year and a half ago. It's a thin line GPS watch. It's got a worldwide airport directory. It also has health features on there. It has heart rate, and it detects pulse oximeter, percent blood oxygen. So when you're flying above 10,000 feet, for example, you can monitor your percent blood oxygen right from your watch. It also will, parrot your text messages and information from, if you want to hook it up to our Garmin InReach portable, that's our Iridium satellite transceiver. You can send and receive text messages via Iridium and read them on your watch. So pretty neat capabilities there. And you can set it up. I set up mine so that it automatically gives you all the current METAR information for the closest airport. So you can see where the winds are, what the altimeter is at all times. We have the Era 760. This was another new product. We came out during the pandemic. This replaces the Era 796. It has a faster processor, much better screen. It will interface with our Garmin portable GDL50 series ADS-B-N receivers, and makes a very nice complement electronic flight bag for the cockpit. And then the GDL50, that is, we have the GDL50, that's ADS-B N traffic and weather receiver. We have the GDL52 that does the ADS-B functionality and adds XM weather and XM music. So you can get a very nice aviation ADS-B and XM receiver. And the nice thing about these systems is then you can take it home. If you've got you can Bluetooth it to the stereo on your boat or in your car or at your home stereo, and you've got a XM receiver for that too. Okay, so our portables rebate that we're running right now is if you get an Era 760, it's a $100 rebate for our that's for our U.S. and Canadian customers, the mail-in rebate. Talk to your Garmin dealer if you're an international dealer, and we work out other arrangements. We have a $75 rebate for the D2 Delta series and a $50 or $100 rebate for the GDL50 and GDL52, respectively. So those are our dual GI275 kits we talked about before, $79.95 and $84.95. Again, the synthetic vision, we've cut the price in half. So it's a nice promotion. This promotion is going through June 18th, 2021. And if you wanna come over and see the GI275, please come to the Garmin booth. We're in Hangar D, you can see that. And you can also see the GI275 on four different airplanes we have here at the show on static display. And I'm gonna show those to you right now. The first one, this has got to be the nicest Cessna 414 on planet Earth. And it's right over there. It's right by the announcer stand. It has a GFC 600, G600 TXI with engine indication system, dual GTN 750 XIs with TAWS-B, the GCU 45, that's the little PFD controller. Really nice touch. He put it down below the throttle quadrant. So you have an extra heading and altitude pre-select knob down there. GDL69A, that's the XM receiver, GTS855, active traffic system, GTX345, ADS-B in transponder, so it synchronizes and blends the active traffic. You get the range advantage of the active traffic system, it goes out to 80 miles, but then when you get within the ADS-B range, it adds the relative motion target trend vector. So you get the best of both worlds. GWX75, that's our new 16 color weather radar for twin engine airplanes. And the GMA35C remote Bluetooth audio panel with Telligence voice command. The Telligence, to get that, you need the Garmin audio panel. Your installer will install in a yoke aircraft, typically the right trigger finger, because your left trigger finger is your VHF transmit. So right trigger finger, you push the button, speak the command, and it carries out 300 different commands on your GTM. The next, again, this is up at the show at the entrance near the announcer stand. That's Boca Air Maintenance out of Boca Raton, Florida, did this one. The next one, this is the Cirrus SR-22 that's outside of Hangar C. This is actually a dated picture. It does have the G500 TXI with EIS, a GTN 750, 650, but that third party standby has been updated with a GI275. Notice, you know, in the older Cirruses, you had three standby instruments, and that's true of a lot of legacy aircraft. You had airspeed, attitude, and altimeter, right? With a vacuum system. Well, now you can replace those three instruments with a single instrument, a GI275. Then you have, we updated the GPS navcoms to the GTN 750 XI, 650 XI, and then used the remote audio panel, the GMA35C, and remote ADS-B transponder, the GTX345. You can see this airplane upgraded. Oh, by the way, this has GFC 500 autopilot as well. So it updated the original STEC 55X to a GFC 500. Now, why do that? Well, you go from a two-axis autopilot, you know, bank and pitch, to now bank, pitch, and yaw. It adds a yaw damper. And it turns it into an attitude-based autopilot, so you can now have indicated airspeed climbs and descents, coupled descent VNAV, all on your Cirrus. And all of your autopilot enunciations are on your PFD and on the GI 275, okay? One other note about the G500 TXI, the new system software version 3.12 gives you the option of putting EIS and a full screen MFD on the right side. So when you talk to your Garmin dealer, ask them which configuration you want. You can have it with dual PFDs, with single or dual AHARs, or you could have a single AHARs with a full screen MFD on the right side. So it's really very flexible that way. You can customize it to your specifications. Please take a look at some of these airplanes at the show though. Here's another one. This is another Sarasota airplane. It's outside of Hangar C, right next to the Cirrus. Here he's got dual G500 TXIs, dual GTN 750s in the middle. He's got that GCU autopilot controller. Notice that's a third-party autopilot in there, because we haven't covered the Aztec yet. But you can control the third-party autopilot with that Garmin heading and altitude pre-select knob. It's just below the autopilot. He's got the GI 275 standby, and I think he's showing a movie on there. He's got a DVD player on that plane. Very well equipped, as you can see. So that's outside of Hangar C as well. So take a look at that Aztec. It's a really nice airplane. Finally, for you Bonanza folks out there, this has got to be one of the nicest F-33 Bonanzas on planet Earth. And it's parked right out here by Hangar D outside. Tomlinson Avionics in Fort Myers, Florida. It's got, in the center, a full screen G500 TXI primary flight display, engine indication system with percent power. You know, that's referenced in the Cirrus pilot operating handbook. So we've added percent power to the TXI, full screen, MFD, and then we're using the new GTN software. So you see the GTN 750, the number two one, it's way over on the right. He can control both VHF comms from the left side GTN that's right in front of him. So it's really leveraging a lot of our new capabilities for the GTN and the G500 TXI. Then he's got dual G5 backup displays down below. Again, outside of Hangar D. So we've got the F-33 outside Hangar D, we've got the SR-22 Cirrus and the Piper Aztec outside of Hangar C at Sarasota. And then the Cessna 414 at Boca Air Maintenance right out by the front gate here. All right, everyone. Well, looks like I've got 2 minutes to spare.